Hello viewers, welcome to you again in C++ programming. Today we are going to discuss about the important concepts of C++ programming. The important concepts in C++ programming. So what is function in C++ and types of functions in C++ in programming with example. So what is a function? Function is a very important concept of programming. So let's move on and know about what is a function. Function is a set of instructions that are designed to perform specific tasks. Function is just a set of instructions. It contains data types, it contains operations, it contains nothing, but it contains instructions that are designed to perform some specific task. Like if we multiply something, we use function. If we calculating the area of something, we need a function. We passing the value towards that function and that function calculate. So that is area function. Similarly, there are a lot of function that are used for specific operations, but a function contain a set of instructions, mean instruction for calculating something that we want. So a function is a complete and independent program. Function doesn't depend on something. Function is as a whole is a complete and independent program from the other program parts. So function is always executed by main or any other functions of program to perform itself. So function is always been a declared. It can be called. So it can be used by other functions. Like if you want to calculate the area, so in one function we declare data types and in another function we want to calculate that area. So we call area function by the help of some other functions, because one function contain data and the other function can calculate the area. So it's depend upon the use that where we want use in. It depend upon the user and how can you use the functions. So let's move on. So types of function, basically in programming or in C++ programming, we have two types of functions, built-in function and user-defined functions. So built-in functions and user-defined function. So what is built-in? So the built-in functions that have already been defined as a part of the label. So these are the types of function which is already defined. It doesn't need to be defined, which is already known by the compiler. So means all of these functions are defined in header file. So it can be used in any problem in any programs. So it can be used for any kind of operations. So it is called built-in function. Built-in function have a lot of importance. So in the coming tutorial, we will know that why the built-in functions are important. So what are built-in functions? So here on the screen there is a main function, and I had comment out that this is a built-in function. So main we cannot define to the header file that what is main. So main is already defined to the header file of the program. So main is a built-in function. So the functions, what are the user-defined functions? The function created by user are called user-defined function. Means we create functions for our own specific problem, to perform some kind of operations, to perform some kind of work we want. So we created our own function. The function that are defined, created by the user, are called user defined function. So it can be used for specific purpose. Means we earlier discussed that we use it for some kind of operations, like calculating area, calculating sum, calculating any kind of operation that we want. This is used for specific purpose. So user defined function had three parts: function declaration, function definition and function calling. So what are these three important parts? So let's move on. So function declaration. So what is function and how we can declare function? What is function, as we earlier discussed. So now type of function. So this is really very important. we clarify that type, what is the type, function name and arguments. So these three important things should be noted, that we clearly define what is the type, what is the name of the function and arguments that the function contains. So type specify the data type such as int, float, it mean the type, function name, whatever the name of the function that we want, like eg void is just been used that return nothing. Int is a data type, sum is the name of the function, and int is the argument that function. So these things are really little bit confusion, but as we move on it will clarify to you. So function had three important parts when we have want to declare it, at the type, the name of the function and the arguments. So the argument are not necessary if you use arguments or not, but these two things are important. We specify the data type, integer, float, whatever we want, the name of the function, and this is the, we can we have no need to use the arguments. Arguments have a lot of importance, we will clarify to later in the next tutorial. So this is syntax for a function. This is type of the function, type, function name and arguments. This is the open and closing curly braces, and this is the step in whatever the function. So this is a clear overview about the functions. What is a function? A set of instructions that are designed to perform some specific task. A function is a complete and independent program. Function as executed by a main or any other function of the program. So function can communicate with each other. As a program have a lot of functions, we have clarified two types of function, which is a built-in function, user defined function. The function that have already been defined as a part of the language, which are called the user, the built-in function, such as main function is a built-in function, and user defined function that is created by user for its own purpose, for its own use. Function have three important parts: function name, function declaration, function definition, function calling. So first we explain this process for function declaration. We specify the type, the function name and the arguments. So this is the simple thing, that it is a type, it is the name and it is the arguments. In the next tutorial we will explain you about what is function definition and what is function calling. Thanks for watching.